Here's a song about how when you're having a nice day with the weather's nice, you just feel really good. It's a beautiful day. It's a beautiful day. It's a happy sun. It's a happy sun. The birds are singing. The birds are singing. The ducks are quacking. The ducks are quacking. It's a beautiful day.
I'm Beth Zerkowski, and this is
Superman. Clark Kent. Are you Lois? No, I'm just kidding. Art Paul.
Yes, this is Art Paul. Today we're going to be talking about painting.
Super Art Paul.
Talking about art, just like art.
Oh yeah.
Art's art.
Yeah, I like to do art. Do you like art?
Yes, I love art.
I'm art, and you, do you draw, or?
Yeah, I draw, and then I paint with watercolors.
Wow, that's fun.
Yeah.
I could paint with watercolors, but I like acrylics better. I feel acrylics are like halfway between oil and watercolors.
Oh.
I mean, they have some of the traits of a watercolor, and some of the traits of oil painting.
I don't really like oil paints that much because you have to stink up your whole house with the.
That's one of the traits that acrylics don't have that the watercolors don't have. That's why acrylics are closer to watercolors, because they don't have that smell.
Yeah.
But they can get really thick. You can make acrylic paint stand up if you wanted to.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because it's kind of a plastic, isn't it?
Yeah, that's, yeah, I don't know if it's recyclable, though. That's scary.
Do you go someplace, like to a community art center to make your paintings?
Let's see, where do I make my paintings? I could if someone invited me to some, hey, we're all gonna paint today. One day I did, this lady had a park show, and she said, I'm having a paint party. And we all went there and ate food and drank whatever we had and painted. And I painted her and made her into like a fairy. And my friend Chris, who's a dentist, bought the fairy, I think, because of the tooth fairy or something.
Yeah.
I made her look like a fairy because she was wearing wings, because she was wearing a costume. So I turned her into a fairy, and then he bought it. Sometimes I like to do portraits where I make them into something. Like one time I this guy that films me a lot.
Yeah.
He had his face on Facebook, and he was wearing a hat that looked like a crown. So I made a crown and put it on his head and called him the king. And then someone wanted to buy the king, so they bought the painting.
Wow.
I think sometimes when I do a portrait of someone, people buy them, especially if it looks interesting. Because I did one of Joan Baez. I went to, she did that show. We all went to Washington, D.C., and she was there singing protest songs.
Okay.
And she, her hair is cut short, and parts of it is like has turned white now, so she looks kind of like a punker, because some of it's still dark. And so I painted her, and these two people that went were on the protest on the bus. They liked the painting, and they bought it from me.
Oh, okay.
I don't know what it looks like anymore, but it was, I based it on the picture in the newspaper instead of, because I didn't remember what she looked like, but they had a picture of her in the newspaper, so I painted the painting based on that.
And where do you go to paint these then?
Well, I'll paint in my room.
Oh, okay.
Or if I've got the paint with me and stuff, I can paint anywhere. Parks. Well, anywhere it's legal. I don't think you could just get away with it on State Street, because one day I was going to do acrylics on State Street, and the police officer said, you don't have a permit, and I don't know, they didn't want me to paint there, even though people are spray painting. But I guess the people spray paint now have a permit to do it.
Oh.
Yeah, so maybe that's, but you know, in your room is kind of easy if you have acrylics. If you have oils, that can be messy. You know, if you really want to get someone mad, you leave the bottle of the tube of oil paint, squirt a little bit out on the floor there on a piece of paper right when they have to walk in the door. And boy, they'll be really mad when they have oil paint all over their shoe. And
gets on the rug.
They'll say, how am I going to get that out? Shell works good for oil paint, actually.
Oh, yeah?
I found that if I have oil paint on my hand, you're really supposed to use that other stuff, turpentine?
Turpentine.
You ever turkentine? I was a Turk and I turked in time. Don't say that word, torque. Never mind. Anyways, turpentine you're supposed to use on your hands. But I found that if I spray some shout on there, I can get most of the oil paint off my hand. Using shout.
Oh, wow.
That might be good or bad. I don't know. If you're using shout, make sure you, on your clothes, make sure you wash your hands afterwards.
Yeah.
Because you don't want to, oh, okay, I only had shout. I'm going to have a sandwich. And then, you know, you put some of that shout in your mouth. And I don't know what's in it, but I think it works pretty good. I even had some stains on my clothes, and I used shout, and got, I think they got the acrylic off. I'm not sure if it got the oil or not. But chow was pretty good. Yeah, I like to do a lot of painting. Sometimes I repaint over my paintings.
Do you?
You know, like I did this painting of this just a cloud, and it was all in pink. And it was a cloud, here's what it looks like now. But originally it was just a pink cloud with a pink sun and just pink rain. And I added yellow to the sun, and I added some flowers, and I decided to make the cloud a little darker. And I put a bird, and you know, sometimes you feel like when rain comes, you feel like you're carrying a cross.
Yeah.
So I put a cross in on the painting. This was a remake. But sometimes, most of the time, I just do one painting and don't repaint over it. Here's one I did of an elephant with a crown and blue beard and a white birch tree.
Oh, okay.
It's called Blue Bird, His Elephant, and a White Birch Tree. You know, white birch trees are weird.
Yeah.
You know, they're like, I think God got bored of the regular trees, so. Oh, I'm going to make a white one.
What about the one that, what about on the back? There's some.
Oh, well, sometimes I recycle someone else's painting. I found this painting outside on the ground. So if it turns out to be a masterpiece, I wrecked it and I feel bad. But I don't know. I feel sorry for the Chinese guy that did the original. But I didn't want to look at it anymore. I thought, I can use a canvas. Here's one some of these are remakes. This is another one that's a remake. And this one's called The King Had to Die. And there's a cross. And that's kind of like Jesus there. And he's wearing a scarf. And he's got a crown on his head. And then there's a horse and an eye. And some of this doesn't make sense. But I think this is a slingshot. I don't know why I put it in there. You know, you don't have to, the painting doesn't have to make sense. It just, if someone wants to buy it, you can sell it to them even if it doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
You know, painting is just to relieve stress. And you know, another good thing about painting, it's something fun to do, you know.
Yeah.
You got a bunch of hours, you don't know what to do, you don't like any, you know, I think painting is better than TV.
Yeah. Can be.
Or, well, almost as good as your TV show.
Yeah.
But, you know, because when you're watching TV, you're just staring into a tube and they're doing all your work for you. But when you actually sit down and paint and you don't have a TV on, you're making the TV. And no one has to be in the room to watch it, but you are like kind of like the TV. Here's another one that I remade. That one there was just, this one here was just lines going this way and that way. I didn't like it because it didn't make sense. Okay. Are we almost done, or we're done now?
We'll come back after we look at some more of your paintings.
Okay.
Yeah, this is the same show.
Okay.
You're gonna put it on upside down, huh?
Hi.
Hi.
I have a brain.
We're back.
That's why I'm wearing my glasses this way, because I have a brain. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, like I said, this is one that I remade. It was a bunch of flowers, and it looked kind of boring. So I thought I'd add more color to them, and then I added more flowers. They were just all this kind, with the kind of like daisies or whatever you call that, black Susan, black eye Susan. But then I decided to add some tulips and a rose or two, and I call this one have mass flowering. And this is the future I want. Instead of mass destruction or mass shooting, I want us to go around mass flowering. I think villains should buy a bunch of flowers and give them to people.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, let's mass flower people.
You lay it down here.
If
here's a gift for you.
I broke it. Oh, you giving me some payments?
Yeah.
Oh, great. Wow, this will be great. I can take over the world. Where's your car? I'll paint over it. No, I'm just kidding. I wrote a song like that, though. It's called Banksy Graffiti My Car. Unfortunately, I don't have a car, but I thought using Banksy, you know who Banksy is, don't you?
I think I do, yeah.
He's the most famous British artist. What he did was his first painting, he took and broke into the museum and hanged it on the wall somewhere.
Oh, okay.
Without them knowing, he put a painting in there. And then he went around and he puts really beautiful, they're kind of like, you know, you ever watch Alfred Hitchcock, and then at the end of Alfred Hitchcock, there's a black picture of him.
Yeah.
Do you know what that's called?
Silhouette?
Yeah, his graffiti is kind of like silhouettes.
Oh, okay.
Where one of his most famous ones is the little girl. It's a little girl, and she's all black, and she's holding a balloon.
Okay.
Banksy really believes in world peace, and he does a lot of graffiti. And when he does a graffiti somewhere near an apartment, all of a sudden everybody wants to move in that area.
Oh.
Just because of his graffiti. But he's done some political things, like he went to the Great Wall, the Wailing Wall in Israel, and he put up a painting there.
Oh, okay.
And he went to Walt Disneyland in California, and he did a graffiti there. And the guy that was filming him had to destroy his film because the people from the Walt Disneyland came out and they found that guy, but they didn't find Banksy. And they wanted the footage, but he didn't want to give it to them because it wasn't there, so he destroyed it. And
oh.
I saw it in a video. You can watch about Banksy on YouTube. This is what it looks like. He looks like, no, I'm just kidding. This isn't really Banksy. Wouldn't that be funny if this really was what he looked like? No, this is supposed to be everybody. It's called Who. And one of the eyes is brown and the other one's blue, and then some of his skin is dark and some of it's pink like Anglo-Saxon, and some of it's kind of yellow like Chinese, and he's got punk hairdo and a woman's hair, and it's kind of a Who. It's not one person, it's supposed to represent everybody.
Yep.
So that you're supposed to stare at and say, who am I? And then figure out who you are. Or I don't know, maybe not. I don't know why I painted it. But it was a series of paintings. I did one called What? And this lady was trying to figure out what she wanted to do with her life. And so she bought the painting. And then I'd have one called Witch, and I had a friend by that. And then When and Who I still have. And I didn't know how to paint Where. No, I think I painted Where as well. I think there was one I couldn't paint, though. Maybe it was where, I don't know. But I definitely didn't do how. And let's see. Oh, okay, so this is, okay. Maybe it's like that. This is just some weird, well, I call it something green. And it was just, sometimes I'll just take and do these weird squiggly type lines.
Abstract?
Yeah, and then I just color it in or something. And this one I use three different types of green. I have a yellow green, which is more like an olive green. Then I have a regular green. And then I have a green blue that looks more like a gray green blue. If you stare really closely, you can dream about this tonight. And then this one here, I did something special after I painted it. I added, you ever have that
glitter
paint or glitter glue?
Yeah.
I added some glitter on there. I don't know if they can see that. If I go like this, maybe you can. I don't know. It's green with green background. You might not even be able to see the I don't know if you can see this one with green background. Well, you know what they say. Now you see it, now you don't.
You see the black lines.
That's true. Yeah, I just love painting. It's just so much fun. And one of my paintings, the Shepherd Express in Milwaukee?
Yeah.
Well, we did an art show. It's still on until the 30th, but by the time they see this, it'll probably be off. But it was over at Communications. Well, they had some people in Milwaukee and some people in Madison in the show, and they sent a blurb to Milwaukee, and the Shepherd Express, I'm not sure if it was just on their website or in their newspaper as well, but on their website, they put my picture on the Shepherd Express's website.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, it was one of my paintings. It was one called the Things to Come. Something about Things to Come. Or I can't remember the title right now, because sometimes things just go away from your mind and then you don't remember them. Sometimes I remember pictures better than words. But when you remember a picture, you can't always tell people. You know, like if you remember a movie you saw and you remember, you can see the movie, you can't tell people the actor that was in it. Just by remembering the actor,
right.
You have to remember their name as well. And
right.
Words don't always remember like pictures do.
Yep.
Yeah, but it was something about things to come. I don't know, it was all these different images, like it had hearts and diamonds and squares and some
clothes.
You
still have that picture?
Well, it's currently at the, well, it was at the Communications. If no one bought it, I still have it.
Okay.
And now it's time for you to go over there.
Oh. We'll see you later. That's it for tonight.
Bother me anytime at all. Winter, spring, summer, or fall. Bother me if you need a friend. I will lend a hand. Bother me anytime at all. Winter, spring, summer, or fall. Bother, bother me, bother, bother me. If you're in our town, I will be around. Bother, bother me, bother, bother me. It's no bother to me. It will make me happy. Bother, bother me, bother, bother me. If you want to wait in life or soon, let me be the one to make you smile. Even if you're just a little child. Bother, bother me, bother, bother me.
I will be here. I will be, I will be.